We're not touching that. The computer science is actually a good way to start.
Right, and that's how we're starting. We're starting with the computer science, and we're going to start with a computer science AP course, actually. So, you know, we're going to send someone to the AP Institute so that they, the new math teacher that we hire will send her to the AP Institute, and we can put in, you know, a computer science course. So we'll talk more, you know, about a lot of these things.
I just wanted to say, and I've seen it with my daughter's education over the past few years, it's not just social studies class anymore. It's, they integrate art, they make maps in social studies so that she's integrating art. They're doing presentations on Google Docs, so it's learning about presentation. So it's not just art class anymore. It's art, social studies, creative thinking, working together. You got to integrate.
Sure.
You can't compartmentalize the subjects anymore. You got to cross.
Absolutely. Because even STEM, really shouldn't even be thinking of STEM as STEM. Like,
no,
STEM
exactly.
Really is supposed to be incorporated into all of the content areas.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where we want to be. But we have some steps to take in between that. I mean, even with the Chromebook initiative, we have Chromebooks, but we don't want the Chromebook to just be an electronic paper and pencil. But in order to make it not be that, then we need to get teachers on board with that and to get them to, experiment with what the technology can do. We need someone to show, technology, technology coaches or someone to come in and teach them, here, this is the Chromebook, but this is what you can do with it that will help you to do all that collaboration and those project-based things. And so we know where we'd like to go with that, but it's just going to, there's some steps.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I do have to go out and get my kids that revision, but I wanted to also mention, you wanted to cover your social-emotional development students. Do you offer psychology or sociology classes at the high school level?
We have a psychology.
Is it possible to integrate project-based learning into those particular subject areas so that maybe they can work with kids in the elementary level and teach them stress, reduction strategies, or maybe teach them just how to do that? And they're almost like a Big Brother program.
Yeah. And we were just talking about the Big Brother program today as well. And we do have a great, for the elementaries, ADAC, which is the Alcohol Drug Awareness Council of Orange County. We do work very closely with them, and they do come in and they touch upon all the elementary kids, first grade through fourth grade, and we have another program for fifth grade, and they do a program called Too Good for Drugs. But now that we have this new CELEB initiative in New York State, they're coming to see us tomorrow, actually at the Mental Health Coalition, another committee, where they're going to talk about a program that really meets the needs of the CELEB initiative better. So and they do that for free. So that we do, have that as well. So, but that's a great idea to have the kids come down from the high school. And we do have the kids come down from the high school to do destination days where they come down and they talk to the kids about where they went to college, where they're going to college, and they come down and talk to them about, and we send kids from the high school that went to East Coldenhammer or went to Walden, and we get them excited about, going to college and setting a goal and things like that. It's not just college, so it's like if they're going into a trade or something like that.
If you wanted to integrate language arts into that too, one of the other language arts teachers and I spoke today in my school about buddying up, let's say, a seventh grader with a fifth grader who's about to go into middle school, and a seventh grader who's about to be an eighth grader, so that